Hey, a pleasure, good day, everyone. This is Sports Fanatic News. I'm Joe Boric, and this is going to be a quick Reading Royals game preview as they keep playing those same Admirals as every single game I've covered this far for FLYERSNITTYGRITTY has been against the very good Norfolk Admirals opponent that the Reading Royals did not beat on Wednesday, being able to let them come back, but then thwarted any ability for the Admirals to do anything in last night's tilt and won their best game of the season 5-2. After the Admirals had a little bit of pressure early, the Reading Royals controlled the rest of the game. Pat Nagel had another stellar game, Joshua Winquist had another great game, and then Mike Krokok had a great game as well, getting his first goal plus an apple in that game as well. So that was a very exciting game, a very lively game, a game that the Reading Royals controlled throughout the game. As they look to carry that momentum into this evening's tilt and keep playing this team like they did yesterday. Obviously, in hockey, especially in the pros, not necessarily in the ECHL, you don't always have the advantage of seeing these kind of series like this or mini series where you play the same team back to back to back. To me, that's always a benefit because you bounced back after letting them come back. You seem to learn very well from that game and be able to take stuff into the next game to really just never let up. And then, like Kirk MacDonald said, the great coach of the Reading Royals, in a third period, it's just human nature, like the analytics stats. I thought this was a great way to explain it. You kind of throw that out when you're up by more than a two-goal spread because it's human nature a little bit to try to rest your legs a little bit more when you're up 4-1, 5-2. So the one team is going to be pushing the Norfolk Admirals more because they're the team trying to come back, and Reading's going to be more in a defensive position saying, we just got to keep this three-goal lead. So that makes sense. And then, of course, they were up by two for a quick second before Lowe was able to score. But the Reading Royals were a three-goal winner and played a hell of a game last night. And I think that game, that momentum, Dylan asked in the Lions Roar, which is a fantastic video. I always link the Royals YouTube channel from here on out at the end of this video. So if you go there, you can check out the wonderful work he does, plus the great highlights of each game. But he talked about the fact that he asked Kirk MacDonald if you think letting up at the end of the game kind of can go into the next game, and that's when he got into it. It's kind of just human nature when you're up by that much where they did control this game. They played a hell of a game. And if the Royals play anything like they did last night, this is going to be another W again tonight. The interesting factoid about tonight will be, I'm not sure who's going to be in net, if we're going to keep riding with Nagel or if we have to go to Hawkey since he's been playing so many games. But Pat Nagel is a guy that's a veteran in this league, one of the ECHL's best, like Kirk MacDonald told me in the press conference last night. So I wouldn't be shocked if they just keep riding the hot hand there. But of course, he isn't the spring chicken of the league. He is a guy that is 34 and a veteran, so maybe you would put in Hayden Hawkey to give him some rest so you have the all-star goaltender at his best still. But for me, I would just keep riding the hot hand when it comes to Pat Nagel. He's a veteran. He's not necessarily in the last couple seasons. He only played 12 games for Grand Rapids last year and a handful of the year prior. But throughout his career, he's used to having to step in and play a good handful of games. But I don't think that'll be any problem for him. Tonight, I look for, obviously, Cam Strong, the rookie, came on big. I'm not going to say came on strong. That's cheesy. Came on big yesterday, played a good game. He's been playing solid overall. I look for him to continue to grow because it seemed like, at least to me, he had one of his best games yesterday. So that's a good thing for a rookie to build on and grow from. Obviously, Krokok had his best game yesterday. So that's something I look for him and build and grow on. And then when it comes to Winquist, Bykoff, and Lowe, who bounced back from Wednesday's off performance, those are guys I expect to do, especially Winquist and Bykoff. Those guys just do good every night. And then Lowe does all the little things right. He's a guy I expect to do good pretty much every night. Those are players I always look to watch out for. This is a game the Royals just need to come out, play exactly how they did last night. Forced turnovers, especially in that second period, they were forcing a lot of turnovers from the Norfolk Admirals. Force their hand, be able to pressure them along the boards, and just never let up the ante like Kirk MacDonald was talking about before last night's game earlier in the week about that 90%, 10% thing. Just never let up the ante, keep it going, and put pressure on them. And the Reading Royals should be able to take 2 out of 3 from this mini series against the Norfolk Admirals, of course, being able to get the 1 point in the game as well and be able to get the majority of the points in this series. So this has been a preview to the Reading Royals and Norfolk Admirals. Everybody have a great, safe, and pleasant day, and go Royals. Peace out, everybody.